Health care, the death penalty, marijuana laws, all just a few of the topics the leading Democratic candidates for governor squared off on last night. Anthony Brown, Doug Gansler, and Heather Mazur clash in the first Democratic debate. And tonight, we're looking at the impact of the first Democratic debate. We've brought in Dr. John Bullock. You're our first three-peater. So congratulations.
I'm very proud. Glad to be here.
He studies the science of politics at Towson. All right, let's get right to the substance here. Gansler went after Brown on the health care. He can't let go, can he?
No, he can't. And that's something that, from his campaign strategy, is effective, right, to go after one of the leading signature items for lieutenant governor.
All right, after last night, can we still consider Brown the front runner?
I would still say Brown's the front runner, although I think Gansler helps to close that gap a little bit.
All right, Heather Mazur was right in the middle, but she is trying to avoid the fray between both of them, right?
Right, she's clearly smack in the middle. She was avoiding the fray, which to some degree was successful. At the same time, it could be sort of diminishing when the conversation seems to be going between two other figures.
You studied it. Who came out the winner?
I would look at Gansler's coming out the winner there by a nose.
All right, now there are two more Democratic debates. Are we going to see more of the same, or is something going to come out to spark a lot more interest than we're seeing?
I think you're going to see some more of the same. I think you're going to see an aggressive Gansler. I think you're going to see a Brown who's going to try to defend his record. And I think you're going to see a Heather Mazur really tout the impact of her more progressive legislation.
And we have the four Republican candidates. They're going to have their own debate coming up. And what about that side of the race?
Now, that's going to be really interesting. Now, hopefully for them, that's going to increase some energy around that campaign. There's not a whole lot of buzz right now on the Republican side, and that could only help their cause.
All right, this buzz last night, was there a buzz created because of the debate? Now are we going to see it leading up to the June primary?
I think it helps with the buzz a little bit. I know political junkies like myself would definitely, you know, had our ears attuned for it, but seeing it on the front page of the paper, seeing it both in Washington and in Baltimore, I think that does bring a little bit more energy and a little more attention to the campaign now.
Let's break it down. This was held in PG County last night, College Park. There's no Baltimorean in this race. Does that have an impact on the city?
Well, it does have an impact on the city. Many have touted the fact that we see a diminishing population in Baltimore, but also in terms of its political influence in the state. So we see the D.C. suburbs playing a significant role. It'll be interesting to see what that does for turnout. It's not slated to be a high turnout election as it is. That might even be lower in Baltimore, given the fact there isn't a Baltimore-centric candidate.
You're good, Doctor. Dr. John Bullock from Towson University.